So, but the township still holds 10% of whatever the bid price?
It moves down to 5% after a certain time.
Can I give you up-to-date numbers?
All I'm saying, I don't need the specific numbers, I just want to...
Well, we're within budget, we're actually, we are about $1 million yet.
Do we get a discount on our sewer bill then?
What's that?
Do we get a discount on our sewer bill?
I don't know.
So if we're getting $1 million?
One?
Well, I'm sorry, one more, because there was about nonsense the last update when that meeting took place. So if we're to be on a truck from Wisconsin leaving and arriving this weekend for installation...
Tomorrow, should be here tomorrow.
Tomorrow, then we can expect an update on the website by Monday, believe, correct?
I did post something yesterday, and what I gave to you tonight is the most recent update I have.
Okay, thank you.
Dale Morris, Village Drive, so as a result of your sound meter testing around the facility, you decided that there were several possible theories and fixes mentioned in the Roger Phillips email. And one theory was that there was a guitar string effect, where we were having residents just on a hold and let play. And has that idea been thrown out, and so you're just saying you need a bigger silencer at home?
I'm not an engineer, I'm not a sewer engineer, design engineer, I can't comment on that, but...
On the guitar string, okay, it said in there that you could insulate the pipe, which, I'll be honest with you, I ordered the insulation to insulate the pipe. Okay.
I saw your temporary fix that may have voided the warranty on the plant, but it was a good try.
But I ordered the insulation. They did state that they could be wrapped, so I ordered an insulation to wrap it.
Okay.
And I appreciate your efforts.
Instead of...
But we're spending double our sewer bill to pay those guys to do it.
I didn't want to wait to see if they would do it, so I...
I understand that, but for taxpayers' money, Curry, and it's not... Listen, I'm sure we all appreciate your effort to go out there and do it and take an interest to help us resolve our problem. But we're paying these guys millions of dollars, right? $7 million, plus another almost $900,000 or so to Gannett, right? For designing the place, which is not included in the $6 million loan or whatever it was that we used to pay for this, right?
Yes.
So that's why I'm saying, and that's why I felt it was really disturbing that this guy says, I wouldn't buy a house near a sewer plant. Well, guess what, dude? We didn't, you know, we did, but it was quiet for 15 years. Now, your design is causing all of these issues for us.
That's correct.
And it just doesn't seem to me that this guy, by saying that, that's kind of either a condescending or patronizing statement to the people that live in this area. To come out, not to say it once, but say it twice in the same meeting, I wouldn't buy a house.
So you're helping out though with the noise abatement, you're not waiting the warranty?
What are you going to do?
No. I mean, but they can't come back to you and say, you know, we don't owe you anything now.
What are they going to come back and do? I mean, it seems like it was a little slow for them moving, so I ordered it, I have it to be wrapped. I just received. Let them put their silencers on first.
And that's from the Universal guys who said.
But it is stated in his comments that it could be wrapped. It could knock some of the sound out. Could. So it was worth that for a couple hundred bucks.
Okay.
Yes, Paul.
First of all, thank you, Terry. Thank you for everything you tried to do. I really appreciate
you doing that. You know, it's my township as much as anybody else's.
And it's mine too. It's why I started on the planning commission for the last how many years. I mean, I have really a love for these people and a love for this township. I want to see what's best for it. But I also love my house and I love living here. And it's not fair after 25 years that I can't even have my dog sleep clothes made, and I work from home, you know, I have a business as well, and...
And it bothers me, so that's why.
Oh, my God, you know, I was told tonight, why don't you walk in the room and send everybody here an invitation to spend a night at my house and see if anybody shows up. It's not a pleasant place to be, and I love it, you know. But, you know, this has got to be addressed, and what I truly don't understand is it seems to me Saturday night is so bad. I mean, that word, you know, Frederick was going crazy, and I just, I was up, I just witnessed on Sunday, and I was like a zombie. And I just don't understand what happened Saturday. What happened over the weekend? It got so much louder than when you had tried to address it before.
Well, we know they took that light bulb.
Is that what happened? Okay.
So they did take it off.
Okay.
Right? Thank you.
Just an update on the pothole repair. I talked to Tom this afternoon or yesterday about that. He'll have the hot box and be doing some hot patch repairs next week. Upcoming meetings, Planning Commission meets May 18th. Next workshop meeting is May 29th. Under new business, we have some things in the township building that we need to have replaced or repaired. I've gotten quotes for replacement of some rutted tile here in the office area, the lobby, and also some areas down in the police department. Received two bids. One was from Carpet Mart, and that, this all includes insulation as well. That price was $8,008.09, and we also got a quote from Roy Lomas for $8,067. This will be paid from the capital improvement fund. If I could have a motion to approve the Lomas bid.
I'll move.
I'll second.
Any questions? All those in favor say aye.
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 PSATS conference. Myself and the supervisors attended PSATS conference last week. A lot of good workshops, a lot of relevant information that was distributed and disseminated. Your solicitor said that his workshop and conferences went well. He learned a lot from that. I don't know if Marlene wanted to add anything.
This is my first time there, so I didn't know what to expect, and I have to say there's some very useful workshops. I learned a lot from them. I went to one on Act 26. I also went to a workshop on update. It may have been very similar to yours, about zoning and planning update, where they went through some of the recent litigation and talked about why Township either won or lost their cases. And kind of the lesson I took from that is you need to have really good zoning laws and good definitions. So that was also very useful. And it was a good opportunity to network as well. And one thing I took away from it, you know, for whatever the challenges there are here in our small township, there are a lot of places out there who have a lot more challenges and issues than we do. So I think we're in pretty good shape considering, and things are running pretty smoothly. So I was happy about that as well.
Any other public comment? If you could please announce your name and your address, please, loudly, so I can get that information, please.
Doris Swanson, 19 Southwood Station Road, Ziegler.
What is that?
Doris Swanson, 19 Southwood Station Road, Ziegler. I was wondering if you could have a special election it's too soon for May, but maybe in November, to fill lots of space.
There is our election times are set by state law, so we can't have something special for someone.
So how are you going to fill that position?
The present supervisors are going to do their best to advertise it and to interview the people who would like to fill it and appoint somebody to fill it. They're It's up to them.
In other words, the only people that are going to have say in that supervisors, is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. For 30 days after we accept the resignation.
Yeah, I think what would be helpful is, Tom, if you could pull up the relevant language from the law, if you could post that on the website.
Certainly.
We were also asking Tom before the meeting the same thing. We have to comply with state law and regulation, which is the reason we are going to delay accepting the resignation. It gives us a little more time to have a really thorough and thoughtful process. You know, Bob's not here, but he knows as well as anyone, this is not an easy job. It's a hard job. There's a lot you have to do, and nobody's ever happy with you. So, you know, we want to make sure we bring a new person on, that person is qualified and has the right motivation and will join us to do a good job in this community. So we are going to enter into a thoughtful process. It will happen in public. So people who are interested will have an opportunity to talk about themselves and why they're interested, and people have an opportunity to ask them questions.
Terry.
Terry Bird, 40 Little Road. So to close on the, Kevin, to you for the ASA, so the advisory committee is still Terry Sachs, Reverend Roth, Mrs. Kenny, and myself, I believe. Is that something, Kevin, you'll coordinate the first meeting? And
yes.
There'll be a public announcement and an open to public on that.
Wasn't Dan Murphy?
Oh, I don't know. Who's on the way?
I think I am.
So maybe I have a question. Who's on the advisory committee?
I don't have a list here in front of me. I know Terry was, you were. We just appointed two last meeting.
It was Reverend Jim Roth, Ellen Jane Kenny, and Dan Moore. So the board of five is completely filled.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. So Kevin McCourney. Okay. One other item. So the upcoming planning commission meeting, just to make sure, May 18th on the paper, on the agenda, that's a Friday. Is that a typo or? You have May 18th as the next planning commission meeting? That's a Friday.
Okay, the 17th.
The 17th.
I'm saying this Thursday.
Okay. Thank you.
Run.
Just a general comment. You all know I keep everybody updated on blood drives and so forth. There's going to be another one at the current campground at the Rental Library on the 25th.
Thank you.
Oh, I've been there. And I'll tell you what, spots go up there. So go online, register. I'll be there again. And it's the latest one at the Bush Library Firehouse 3 weeks ago. Again. And that was full. And when I went in there, everything was full. So it's a good cause. I'm always bringing stuff up. So that's the next thing coming around the pipe for the library. I'd rather go on. Easy to get to. Come up Church Road, right?
Yep.
And I don't know the hours on the 25th.
It's on the Friday the 25th. It's going to be 2 to 7.
That's all. Thank you.
Yes.
Tom, just a question for you. Is there a limit to the amount of time that we can delay accepting Bob's resignation?
There's no cases that I know that has that, but my advice would be that we limit that until the next meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Chair.
Shannon Fidel, South Station Road.
What was it for? What's the name?
Perfidial. It's 101 South Station Road. Are you doing that Memorial Day flea market thing in Dakota Park again this year?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm Ryan Lee, I'm branch manager of Park Valley Library. We're closed drives going to be held. I brought in, we usually do a quarterly newsletter, but we only have 1 month left, so we modified it since just for May. In May, we've got a lot of programs. We've got a Star Wars program. We've got the blood drive. But we're also doing a spotted lantern fly workshop. That workshop, I mean, that bug's driving us all crazy. The Penn State extension is coming out, and she'll have some great information to share with us about what to do with it. This bug is set to eat a lot of crops. See, bugs and nuisance, this one's really, really bad. But I've got my little activity flyer right now. At the end of the month, I'll be bringing you the summer flyer. Summer is June, July, and August. We've got Libraries Rock is our theme, so we've got all kinds of cool music, great programs for adults, kids, a lot of stuff going on. And I wanted to announce we have a fundraiser that Norristown does. Norristown is our main library and helps control my book budget. And this fundraiser goes directly to the budget for the books. It's a $50 ticket for the fundraiser. It's at the Elmwood Zoo, June 7th, 5 to 8. For the $50 ticket, you get refreshments, hors d'oeuvres, drinks, lots of great music from the in-town band, which is great jazz music for the jazz. So please help support the library, come out and check out the cool programs, and we'll see you hopefully at the library. Yes.
What is the date for this lantern fly?
Spot of lantern fly is Tuesday, May 22nd, 6:30 p.m. She will talk to one person, she will talk to another.
I want to ask Kevin, could you put the spot of lantern fly workshop on our calendar? Because I know a lot of people are interested in that, including myself.
Just an FYI, I have some, the frequently asked question flyers and the contact information can't help you with it, but I just want to let you know if you're interested in it. It's a pretty large tax savings for the larger properties.
Thank you.
Is that something that you want to put on the website for consumption?
I mean, it could be just a link to the county to ask questions.
I just want to send you that link there.
Yeah, of course.
Thanks.
Brian, 1120 Road. Over the last several months, and I'm assuming you all have all seen this, driving through our, not only our communities, but the communities that are adjacent to us, the noticeable amount of trash that is on the side of the road. And I spent 2 weekends within the month of April walking Ziegler Road, picking up trash that is either being tossed or being blown from trash cans. I would suggest that the township begin to think of some way, maybe an initiative or something of that nature. We're all talking about building a community, but if we continue to build a community that has a lot of trash in it, it's just not becoming an area.
I did talk to Tom about that. Apparently, the way the wind blows up there, that's what's causing
it. It's not even that. I mean, you can drive 29, you can drive anywhere in this area and find a tremendous amount of trash. And some of it is, I see from on Ziegler, a lot of it coming from the Wawa. But if you drive 29, it's not people who are going from Wawa, it's anybody throwing trash out their windows or blowing. But I think we as a community need to begin to think about it is our community, it is our trash, and we need to take the time to, if we see it, let's do something about it. I actually get to meet two people I never knew on my street for the 24 years that I've lived on my street. So it's also an opportunity to meet your neighbors, but I think we need to actively begin to think about, it's a respect issue. You know, you have someone come through from another area, coming through your community. I mean, I don't want to live in Philadelphia. I don't want to look like I live in Philadelphia. And so, you know, let's do something about it. And whether it's something that we need to organize or if it's something that we just do as community members, you see it, take it up, throw it in, you know, take an hour of your day. I don't know, but we can't keep on doing what we're doing here. It's just, I think it's disrespectful to the neighbor, it's disrespectful, and it's just disgusting.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Liz Jansen, Senator Road. To reiterate on what Mr. Hill has said, some communities, and I believe this idea came from Dan Work, some communities have what's called an Adopt a Road program. So maybe that's something. Now I realize that wouldn't apply, I mean, I'm sure you'd have to go through PennDOT and things like that for the state roads, but maybe that's an initiative we could start within the township on our township roads, you know, Adopt a Road. And even if, you know, like, just to try to encourage me to get a little plaque or sign that this road is maintained by the Smith family or the Sachs family, or do something like that, and maybe that could be, to give the people the recognition if they adopt the road and then they clean it up, maybe it might be an idea we could look towards. I don't